Hi everyone and welcome to this new video. We start with the concept of power factor correction. That is our example number one. What do we have? We have a power supply for power source Vs. We have a series combination of the inductor and the resistor here, which is a model of inductive load. And the values of the resistor and the inductor are given here, 5 ohms and 20 millihenries. The voltage supply is also given here, the value of that. And the question in place here is determine the value of the required value of the capacitor C to make the power factor equal to 1. So without the capacitor here in parallel, the power factor of this circuit will not be 1 because there is also an inductive part of it. So we would like to make this power factor exactly equal to 1. So how can you work this, how can you make the solution come up to the power factor of equal to 1. There are different ways to do this. What I want to do, what I would like to describe today, is discuss today, is the following. I would like to convert this, transform this circuit part, this RL series section. I would like to transform this to a parallel configuration. Why? Then I can exactly equate the new value, the parallel inductor, to the reactants such that they cancel each other and compensate, and such that I have the power factor equal to 1. So what I want to do is the following. I will redraw the circuit so this is clear what I want to do. So this is actually the situation, and I have a new value after the transformation for the resistor. There's a resistor P, so resistor parallel. There is also a new value for the inductor, so that will be LP, and the capacitor will again be connected parallel, so we can place the same capacitor here, so that will be C. So if I know the inductor value after the calculations, then I know, of course, the reactance of that. I can equate this to the reactance of the capacitor, and from that, using the formula of the reactance of the capacitor XC, I can calculate the capacitor value C. So that's actually the procedure which I want to follow here. So first, let me look at the original circuit, of course, without the capacitor, just the voltage source and the resistor and the inductor in series, and I would like to determine the impedance, and from that I will convert this to the admittance. So let's move on first to the impedance Z is equal to the resistor in series with the reactance of the inductor. But the reactance of the inductor, which is not determined yet, we have to use this formula, omega times the inductance, which is 300 times 0.02, which will bring us to 6 ohms. That will result in 5 plus J 6 ohms. That's actually the situation for the impedance. And I can convert this to the polar notation using the already known formulas for the phases. So what I have is a 7.81 phase, 50 degrees, again in ohms. Now I will convert this to admittance. So Y is equal to 1 over Z. Why do we do this? Because converting the impedance to admittance will bring us to an expression which will clearly designate the parallel components, so it will be clear when we are done with the expression for Y. Then you can see directly that is the reactance of the new inductor expression, or the new inductor LP. So let's move on, and I will illustrate this shortly. So that's actually 1 over 7.81 phase of 50. How do we calculate now this? It's very easy, actually. It's 1 over 7.81. That's actually the amplitude for the Y. And the phase will be 0 degrees minus 50 degrees. So it will be minus 50 degrees. So what you get is here 0.128 minus 50 degrees in Siemens. That's actually the unit of admittance. Now I will now convert this the rectangular form, because from that I can determine the separate parts, so the RP and the LP, and the value of the XLP, so the reactance of LP, will be also clear. So what I have is the following: 0.128 times the cosine of the minus 50 degrees and plus J sine of minus 50 degrees. And I will get the following expression, that is 0.082 minus J 0.0898, and also again in Siemens. Okay, now the next step is important, such that the calculation will be easier and also much shorter. This expression 0.082 and this expression 0.098, I would like to write it in a different form. So I will like to write it in 1 over something will bring me to 0.082, and I, again, 1 over something will bring me to 0.098. So what are the expression for that? Let's make a template clear for this. So it is 1 over something plus 1 over J times something. So it's J times something. This number will be the reactance actually of this LP, and this number will be the value of this RP. So how do you calculate this? It's very easy actually. It's just 1 over the 0.082 will bring actually the value here is 12.2, and exactly the same situation for the other one will bring this to 10.2. Again, this is again in Siemens, and what you see here clearly, this is the, I will designate this, this is the RP, this is the RP, and this is the value for LP. So LP, or I mean XLP, excuse me. So XLP is also clear. Now for making the power factor equal to 1, I would like to have that the reactance of the capacitor and the reactance of this inductor exactly to equal to each other. That's actually the situation also for resonance. That will mean that these two components will produce an open circuit, so the voltage supply will deliver as total power to the resistor RP. Okay, let's move on. Let's make this situation for XC must be equal to XLP, which is 10.2 ohms. But what is the value, or what is the expression for XC? XC is the reactance of the capacitor is 1 over the omega times C. And I would like to determine the C, so I am really close. C is equal to 1 over omega times XC. That means 1 over 300, that was given in the in question, times 10.2, which is 327 microfarads. And I'm already done. It's actually the capacitor value for this circuit. For this situation, I will need a capacitor of 327 microfarads. Now, of course, this is the example number one. We will continue with other examples, considering the power factor correction, also steady state power calculation and design. So keep in touch and see you next time.